Lazy Dude 99. Batman fan, and I'm a Canadian man. I do top 10 lists, and I eat ketchup chips.
Hello. Welcome. I am LazyDude99, and I am here to show you the top 10 movie villains. Alright. Hi guys, it's me again. So, why I have decided to do this? Well, I thought I would go into the three basic characters that you need for a movie and do my top 10 list of them. Movie villains, leading lady, and main character. And just to be clear, even if the movie's main character is a lady, that still is the leading lady. I mean, even if it's the ladies and as a side character, it still is the leading lady, right? So, enough about that. Let's go into the world of the evil movie.
Away, so
go ahead. Run away, say it was horrible. Spread the word, tell a friend, tell them the tale. Get a pick, to applaud, heroes are over with. Look at him, not a word, hammer me nail. Then I win, then I get everything I ever. All the cash, all the fame, and social change. Anarchy, then I run, it's Dr. Horrible's turn. You people are
number 10. Number 10, The Nothing from The NeverEnding Story. Now, The NeverEnding Story is a really old fantasy film, and its villain is basically this thing called The Nothing. It is basically this thing that's just destroying everything in this world. You don't know how, you don't know why, all you know is that there's this nothing destroying everything and making everything nothing. It has this sort of whole, like this immensely powerful feeling over it, and you feel like the character you're watching, Atreyu, will just vanish off the screen if it comes near it. You actually feel really menaced from it, even though it doesn't have a face, it doesn't really have, it cannot speak. It has a spokesperson, this really kind of cool, terrifying wolf creature. But it's just this nothing. And I always loved the nothing. I thought it was an amazing idea. And it is just such a great even though it's not really a character, it is still the main villain in the movie. And the nothing is the way that I start out my list at number 10.
You people all have to learn, this world is going to burn.
Number 9. Number 9, Doc Ock. Yep, you can see that I'm having a few comic book villains here. But honestly, Doc Ock, Alfred Molina, played a great job with Doc Ock. I mean, I know that in comics, Doc Ock isn't really an understandable villain. Like, oh, he had a life and he was a nice guy and then he went bad. I don't think it's exactly that way in the comics, but I don't care. This, he did a great interpretation. This is not exactly what's best to its background origins. This is just how the performance was and how the thing was portrayed. Now, Doc Ock, Alfred Molina did a great job about this man who's getting tortured by these things. And he made the tentacles really seem like they were talking to him, you know? So, like, you know, you felt like they were real people in tentacle form convincing him to do evil things. I mean, he was really creepy. The music to him was really good. And like, scenes like the hospital scene where he's not even awake yet. He's still unconscious, and the tentacles go and they kill all these doctors. It is a very suspenseful and terrifying scene. And you know, you just feel right there. Like, he's asleep on the table and he's still causing all this destruction. You feel right there that he's going to be a great villain. And he is. And he goes all the way to number 9.
Number 8.
Professor Fate! Okay, if you guys do not know who Professor Fate is, don't worry about it. There's this really old movie called The Great Race. Its basic story is there's these two daredevils. One is called the Great Leslie. He is the all-around nice guy, charming, romantic, and, you know, he's always dressed in white. When he smiles, his teeth sparkle. Anyway, his counterpart, villain, is called Professor Fate. Exact opposite. Evil, dark, brooding, and always wears black. However, Professor Fate isn't a scary villain. He's an hilarious villain. It isn't easy pulling off an hilarious villain. I mean, I love Jack Lemmon's portrayal of this guy. He's always yelling, always cranky, and he's always trying to get Leslie. You know, he almost has this sort of, sometimes there's some Looney Tunes style performances here. Like, there's a scene where he lets loose a torpedo to try to kill Leslie. The torpedo has a sound signature to catch on the loudest sound. As they're trying to get away, they turn on their car, and the car has the loudest noise, so the torpedo goes and hits them and blows them up, but they're okay, right? Sort of, you know how Looney Tunes, they'll always blow up, but they'll be fine. They'll be like a little scarred, but they'll be fine. But Professor Fate is such an amazing villain. I love the heck out of this guy. If you watch the Nostalgia Critic's reviews, he said in his top 10 movie comedies, because The Great Race was on that list, that Professor Fate is where he got a lot of the Nostalgia Critic stuff from. And I can see it. I can see it right there. And Professor Fate is an amazing villain. If you haven't seen The Great Race, check it out, please. Because this guy is one of the best villains around, and has one of the coolest movie vehicles ever.
It's ready. Yes. Yes, it's ready. There has never been anything like this. Professor, your greatest creation.
Genius, work of genius, the finest parts from the greatest automobiles in the world. The Hannibal Twin Apes.
And when it comes to the blizzards and the snowstorms, we will continue on just as planned. Push the button, Max.
When the rains come and when the snow melts, we shall continue to rise above it.
Push the button, Max.
Nature! Russia will chase us, we will beat her. And brigands, thieves, cutthroats of all nations may hound us, but we are ready for them.
No way, so...
To see the rest of my list, go to part 2.